Good afternoon. Today the 14th October. This is an off class. Today we'll how to create a linked list in Python. We would like to show, and the linked list is immensely powerful than array. Array has some limitation. Array you can quickly find it an element by index, but linked list you cannot quickly find it out. You have to insert. You have to access it either from the front or at the end. But the linked list, adding something in the front, adding something in the end is O1. But array it is not. Array, because if you have to add something into beforehand and after this, you have to shift all the things in array. So in lots of operation, linked list is better, like storing a graph by adjacency list or any tree. It can be better represented in linked list. You know all the tree is very immensely required in any kind of thing like binary search tree or heap. So linked list is very useful. Another thing is linked list doesn't require all the memory to be taken at the initial point. And you can always later you can take the memory and add it to a pointer. And see it is can be easily done by malloc or callop. But array, you have to beforehand you have to allocate a particular memory. That memory will be always blocked. You cannot reuse that array. But in Python you have a dynamic array concept that will come. But linked list is majority of cases, in some cases a linked list is good, because if you want to insert it and delete it from the end, but finding something into the linked list, it is O(n). You have to traverse everything. But insertion deletion is O1, and another thing is you can represent any graph, any tree by a linked list. That is not possible to array. So linked list is very essential. It is already mentioned that linked list is O1 time and it is O(n). Let's continue. Yeah, these are the some data structures is always required whenever you do program. So one is array, which is basic thing, which is available only in C. This ordered array, stack, these are all the data structure which is available in the modern day languages like Java and Python. Array, quick insertion, true. Very fast access, yes, index is known. But it is a slow search, slow deletion. That is linked list. Linked list also O(n). It is also slow search. But linked list deletion is quicker. And it is a fixed size. That is the problem of array, at least for the C. And we'll go to the next slide. We'll see what other data structures. There's a lot of other data structures required. We just now focus with linked list. Linked list is a quick insertion, quick deletion. That is great thing. Slow search. But another thing is not mentioned, that it is dynamically sized. And when it is required, you can take the memory. And there are the other data structures which are partly are available in the modern day languages like Python, and which will help. And the data structure has become more and more intelligent, so that your program can be contained only basic few lines, and the whole data structure, because it is a tested product and it is intelligent and it can manage itself, and the program can be fuelized. That's a great. But if you see everything, you have to put it into in your program. That is your program becomes huge, difficult to maintain. Yeah. So this is the basic difference between array and linked list. This more fixed is fixed size. Array is fixed size. Linked list dynamic. Insertion deletion inefficient, because you know insertion, it will then you have to make everything has to be changed, shift to one array. That is very difficult. In insertion deletion is always linked list. It's just it's very efficient. You just put something and put the pointer into it. Random access efficient, but here no random access, you have to O(n). No memory waste, but yes, but whenever you have to pre-allocate the memory, that way some memory is always waste. Here all are dynamically allocated, so no memory waste, but you have to add extra memory address pointed to it. Sequential access is faster, the elements are contiguous, true, because they are put together in this thing. Here sequential access is a bit slower, because you have to go hop by link, so bit slow. Let's do the program. this is the Python program for maintaining a very basic single linked list. Let's go to the program. The size a little bigger. This is the first program. We declare a class node. The node contains a particular data, payload, and a pointer. So we have to. This is the init _init is the constructor of the node, and it is self. Whatever you put into self, remember in the Python, self you can put it in any other name, but it is better to give the name self so that the first name should be always self. And that name should come here. So it can be selfie, here can be selfie. But it is better self, and self is better to be given. So this is the data, whatever is given, you put it data. And next, no data. So it's none. And this is, I have a pointer definition. This is a linked list. I am creating a linked list. This is a doc string. Whenever you have a single, if you have a double, is it two, three more lines, then you have a triple quote here. That is simply a doc string. We can refer it, print it by a print doc string. We'll see. So here the class linked list. Def this one. Head is none. So initialize header, I put it nothing. Then self head. And when the node is none, append. Now I create a list. This is the, I create a linked list. Print linked list __doc. That is a doc string I want to print out. And again, I can print the doc string through the class level or the object level. So both the way, we will see it. This is both the way to see. And print, I can see the print of the ID. There should be object ID in the Python, you know. And I have to see the what is the type. And then I see the print list. And then I add first node. Node A, I add a node. The node is a class and is a object is created. First node is object of class node. List head is equal to first node list. It will print out the list. So let's run this program. Yeah. What is the output? Yeah. See here, first doc string, class linked list working version 1. And this is second doc string, same. And this is the object ID of this a list. And what is the print ID, and there's a, what is the type? It is the same, it is a _ main. So I have this of linked list. So this is our main program under linked list. This is the class. Earlier you have seen int float, then now under we have created a class linked list. So under this, and first is none, because first it was initial is none. Then we say first, say here it is none, then first node is equal to node equal to A, then again print out, then A towards none. First none, then we put A here, then A none. Okay, so now next go to this just as extension this program. We go to second node, another node I am creating, node B. Third node I am creating, node C. Fourth node D. First node next pointer should be second node, definitely linked list, that is the basic. Second node next will be third node next will be fourth node. Let's run this program. See here, see it is come the A, B, C, D, none. Now, let's the next version, class linked list. The second version we make it a little better. We make it a definite, same thing, initialization, self head, and linked list, same. We can run it. it is almost same. Just see. Yeah. Yeah, actually we make it together. All earlier initialize with A and now initial A, B, C, D in one program. Now, you see, this program is to give it to you in the associate document. Now, working version 3, there we have make A, see whatever we have changed. Running the program, we can find it out. Yeah, here we create a linked list. We are not creating one at a time. We give some parameters A, B, C, D, F, or automatically linked list will be created. And how it so it, that must be in the init constructor. So you must see the constructor here. See here, constructor we first none, but if node is not none, then all the things are whatever is the pop and it adding it here itself. So it's basically whenever we're passing on the number of list, it will automatically create the list. So that is a very powerful thing. So this working version 3, you will see that it will automatically this, and not only this, I have a this iter, you know, the iteration I have already put it into this, this iter variable. Then another thing is how to add last. I can add something to the this add last, add after some element, and add after some element, and if it is not there, then there is exception, and all we are trying, add after we have done, add first we have done, add first, so we put something in the beginning of the list. So that is O1, that is a great thing, that is not O1 in array, it may be O(n), because all the things have to be shifted. Add last, that is also O(n) for array, but for linked list, that is O1 operation. That is a great, any tree graph can be handled by the linked list efficiently. So add last, yeah, and add after, this is find a particular node and do after. If the node is not there, it will create an exception, it will raise an exception. You see, if the node is not so, if not, it raise exception, it is not found. So we'll try it. So first we try with list with A, B, C, D, F, and then we'll add first node U, then another V we'll add, and add first U, V, then add last Z, okay. Then I will add C, C after C. That is also okay, and that we will try. There is no such note Q. We try to note CC after it. Then it will raise an exception. But first, without make it a commented, first run this one. Let's see what happens. Yeah. Let's see. Yeah. This is by doc string. It is coming from the class line and the object line. This is object ID. And this is the, what is the class name, that is __ main linked list. And because I have created the linked list by through this parameter, it was automatically created. So that is a great advantage from the first version to this third version. And then I print it in the this way, the print list, and then I print it out. Yeah, and they print it out from vertically. There you can find it out here. This is the command is print list at first. Yes. Print list. Yeah, through for loop for node in I list, print node. So this for loop will make it a vertical print out here. And then we add U to the first node, then add another node O1 in one time V. Then we add Z, fine. Then we add CC after C, fine. Now we try, which was a make a commented one. Yes. Yeah, so we make it uncommented one. on anything. At least the exception. I there is no such note queue, but I want to add CC to it. Let's see, and it will raise an exception. Yeah, it will run, but it raise an exception. It is because it takes the stack, most recent call stack, and it is already said that that node with data queue is not found. Okay, the stack overflow, because everything put on a stack, and the last thing just comes out. Okay, so linked list is a summary. What I have to say, the linked list is very very powerful concept. Every programming language is required, because most of the problems, whatever real life we are solving, we generally put in a graph or tree. So graph and tree, it can be dynamically sized. It will be as the data is coming and going, it will be put in, and it is array is a single dimensional. Even array is a multi-dimensional, then if you put it element into that, a lot of array will be a blank, a lot of wastage. So that is called the sparse array. But linked list, if the data is there, then you can add a pointer. So linked list is space complexity is much less. You can dynamically size. So linked list is very very powerful tool, and any algorithm can work on linked list much better than array, because array you have to find it where the data is, but linked list every data is there in next hop, and addition deletion is O1, that is there. Thank you for viewing this. Thank you.